ANOVA in STATA. When do we use one-way ANOVA? We perform one-way ANOVA to see whether our dependent variable, which is actually continuous in nature, whether this actually significantly differ between three or more group of a categorical variable. Let's see an example in STATA. So we have two variables from this STATA data file. You can see one is the income, another one is occupation. So if this income is $1,000, so it is the annual income. And we have three groups of the occupation. So if you go to the data and variable manager, so under the occupation, you can see we have three group: business, government, and private. So three types of occupation, and we have denoted is as a business for a one, government for two, and three for the private. Okay. So my research question is that whether this income, this is a continuous variable, and whether this actually significantly differ between these different groups of occupation. Okay. So since we are performing one-way ANOVA, so our assumption here is that our continuous variable, that is actually normally distributed. Okay. Now to perform the one-way ANOVA, we have to type one-way, and then I'm doing this under the command option, and my dependent variable, which is actually income, and after that I have to put my independent variable, which is actually categorical variable, that is occupation, and then comma, and I have to type tabulate, okay, and press enter. So I got the result of one-way ANOVA in the STATA, and the first table is showing the mean income level of these three different groups. So the first group has a mean income of 63, and the second one 58, and the third group is 57. And this is the overall mean income for the occupation, okay, and of the respondents regardless of the occupation, okay. This table actually shows whether my research hypothesis, this is actually supports or not, okay. So from this p-value, so this by seeing this significance level, the p-value, so you can see this is less than 1%, or even it is actually less than 0.01%, right? So it is statistically significant. So this supports my research hypothesis that the income that actually significantly differ between different groups of the occupation, right? And this Bartlett's test for equal variance, so this p-value is greater than 5%, so this is non-significant, and this is really good for us, and this actually means that this actually fulfilled the assumption of equal variance, so our one-way ANOVA test is valid. Okay. However, we can further perform post hoc test like Taki, Bonferroni, Sidak, etc. So that we can show the pairwise comparison of the mean. So for this example, I can use Taki test. So to do this, write pw mean, and then your dependent variable. So your dependent variable is the income. Okay, comma, and over, and the bracket, and under the bracket you need to put your independent variable, which is occupation, closing bracket, and then you need to write m compare. Okay, so this is the min compare, and then under the bracket you have to type the test name. So for example, it could be Bonferroni, Sea Duck, or Taki. So for my example, I'm using the Taki, so I just write the Taki, and I want to show the effect. So effects. Okay, so this is the command I'm going to use here. Right, so I got the result here. So this is the result of the Taki test, and this actually showing the comparison of the mean income between the different groups. So 2 versus 1 means so this contrast actually shows the difference result. So 2 minus 1, so income of group 2 minus income of group 1, and this is minus 5 point something, right? So among these different groups, especially I can see this is the statistically significant, right? So this means group 3 income minus group 1 income, which is minus 5. That means this group 3, which is in our case private job holder, they have a mean income which is 5,000 pound lower than the first group, and the first group is our in our example is business, right? And it is statistically significant. So in this way we can perform a one-way ANOVA in STATA.